So we started experimenting with the idea of this thing that we started to call Katie Vision. We found it as a way to highlight her emotions. We're about to break down the secrets of Katie Vision. The Mitchells versus the Machines is about a very normal, relatable family that's put in a kind of crazy position where they find themselves needing to fight the robots in this robot apocalypse. She's our main character.
I'm Katie. I'm sort of a weirdo. My parents haven't figured me out yet.
Katie Vision as a concept kind of came when we were getting closer to finalizing her design, figuring out who she was. She felt very obviously like a creative person. And so we just really wanted it to look like she's finding ways to create all over the place.
I've always felt a little different than everyone else.
It's a mix of 2D animation and really like collaging a lot. There's a burger that's just a photo of a burger, like she found a stock photo online, a photo of a pug, kind of mixed in with 2D.
There you go.
Wow, look at you.
To illustrate Katie Vision further, I'm gonna add it onto a shot that didn't originally have it. So this feels like it could have been a good opportunity to have done some Katie Vision. Here, this is a great example too, where in the lighting team did a lot of really cool graphic things too. This gives me a really great playground too to kind of build on top of it. So I can kind of create a new layer, which is a frame, and then I can just draw directly on it. Maybe this drone, it knows it's gonna be defeated. Maybe I'll give it eyes. And maybe it looks really nervous. We had an artist create this kind of font that we've used to hide messages. Because wherever there's a screen, we'd usually use some hidden message. I've seen some people on Twitter have started to decode it. We'd always try to capture the humor of the movie. Nice. Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Mom,
this is just like in a movie.
Oh, wrong movie, terrible choice.
Hey there.
A lot of the time, Katie Vision is emphasizing like a positive emotion, but it's also kind of emphasized like an extreme one. There's a lot of little like text and jokes. She had just tried to pull something off and it didn't work. So it's fun to kind of see her poking fun at herself. This is an example of rough layout where they're doing rough blocking of character position, really rough animation, and figuring out the camera moves. And so at this stage in the process, I spot a sequence to see, are there any opportunities here for a Katie Vision moment? So you can see in this shot, it's just drawing lines in, but it was enough to kind of talk through with the director about like, does this feel good? Is this something you'd want to pursue?
Ah, who are these unstoppable warriors?
We're the Mitchells, the only people who can save the world. I'm super sorry, everyone.
We worked out Katie Vision in a lot of different ways. Sometimes it came from storyboards, sometimes it came from like a napkin sketch from our director. This is one that the storyboard team blocked in, the worst family of all time text, and we're just kind of embellishing that in design with how Katie sees her family. There's a lot of kind of like wandering thoughts and doodles, adding little hidden text and details so that it feels like she's really like sitting there and having a fun time with it.
I can't wait for you guys to see my new movie.
This kind of movie piece we did is Katie's goodbye video. It's a movie that she's made to say goodbye to her family before going off to college and something she's really proud of. And it's supposed to feel like someone Katie's age is making it. Katie Vision film style is you get things that are a little quirky and it's fun to celebrate that. We had puppets given to us in the storyboards and there was a world where we could have built it in 3D. It was something we ended up just doing physically. We would actually just record puppets against a green screen. This is in my office with construction paper taped up. I think we had like a room at the studio with like a proper green screen and lighting rig, but it was a mix of wanting it to be good enough as someone who like our character really cares about her craft, but letting it be a little flawed.
See, this is good right here. This is natural.
Make sure to check out The Mitchells versus the Machines. It's streaming now only on Netflix.